Okay, so if you have finished your registration with Swing Logic and you've got your license key that was emailed to you, or you've drug over it and copied it on the keyboard, this is where things start to get a little more complex, and that's in the setup of E6. So if you've already downloaded E6 and set up an account, you can go to portal.e6golf.com and log in there. If not, you can go through the sign up process here. An important part of the sign up process, whether you've already done it before or whether you're signing up for the first time, is to ensure that you verify your email with E6. When you register with them, they will send you an email that comes from a no reply at e6golf.com type of address. And often we find that that is filtered to people's junk or spam folder. So be sure that if you haven't verified your email address, you do that. If you've got a login, you can come directly to this screen and log in. So I'm going to log in here into my specific portal at E6 Golf, and this is what'll pop up. If it's on a phone, it'll be a little bit smaller, but if it's on your web page, what we need to do is go over to where we can find licenses. You may have to scroll down some. When you click on licenses, it'll pop you up and you'll be able to see all the available licenses that are tied to your specific account. If you have not already redeemed the key that we emailed to you, this is where you can easily redeem that key. If you have it from the email from us, you can copy and paste it in here. If you wrote it down, you can type it into here, and then you'll need to hit submit. If this submit button is grayed out, that's a indication that you have yet to verify your email directly with TrueGolf. So if you put in your product key and you're able to submit it, great, it'll tie this license to your account. If not, then you need to make sure you verify that email address in your spam or junk folder. So I've gone ahead and copied over a product key from my Swing Logic login. Right, and I've got one. It starts with TXP, so I know it's for a PC. If it starts with TXM, I know it's for a Mac because they're not interchangeable. So I'm going to come over here. I've drug over that with my mouse or hovered over it with my iPad, copied it, come back to E6. I'm going to come over and I'm going to hit paste, right, to redeem it. It's going to say, "Ooh, sorry, there's a problem. Product key has already been redeemed." If you see this message, then you have already redeemed this key with E6. You may have done it from within their mobile app, or you may have already done it here through the portal. That's okay. You don't need to re-redeem it. That means that license already exists. I've already redeemed this. I wanted to show you what that would look like if that happens. It's this particular license, right? SLX Tittle license. Actually, there's my mobile license. I know that that was a PC license. So I can scroll down and say, okay, yep, here was the PC license. Tittle PC standard 5-course 1-year license. Okay, so that's been applied to my account. You can see all these other potential licenses. And again, we're sorry, E6's licensing system can be fairly complex, but it's to ensure that you can only use a license with one username and one device at a time. So you can't share your E6 membership with other people because it's a expensive software package. So if you've made it to this screen and you see multiple licenses, okay, some of the licenses are going to be tied to demos, et cetera. If you skipped any of this and you automatically downloaded E6 Connect and set up, they will give you a 15-day free demo license. So you may look in here and you may see a license that just says something about 15 days. And if that license has the word unbind in a red box next to it, you're going to want to click on that to tell it to unbind. So just to show you what that looks like, I'm going to unbind this particular mobile license from what it's tied to right now, which I believe is my iPad. Yep. So if I click on unbind, are you sure you want to unbind this license? I'm going to say yes. Okay. That license was successfully unbound from that mobile device. All that means is the next time I log into E6 Connect on my iPad, it's going to make me select which license I want to activate for that device. So I'll have to scroll down, find that license again, and tell it to activate.